Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss a very important reaction based on the cleavage of OH bond, which is nothing but esterification. So what happens in esterification is that alcohols or phenols react with carboxylic acid, acid chloride or acid anhydrides to give esters. So as you can see here, the reaction of alcohol or phenol with carboxylic acid and acid anhydride are reversible in nature, in contrast to the reaction with acid chloride. So as you can see, since these are reversible in nature, the byproducts obtained in each of these reactions, which is water and acid, needs to be continuously removed in order to drive the reaction in the forward direction. Now as you can see, in this reaction where we are reacting an alcohol or a phenol with acid chloride, we usually employ a very strong base like pyridine. Now the function of pyridine is that we know pyridine is a strong base, so essentially its function is to neutralize the byproduct, which is HCl, formed in this particular reaction. Now esterification reactions in which we add an acetyl group to either an alcohol or phenol is called acetylation. So a common example of acetylation reaction is nothing but acetylation of salicylic acid, in which case the product that we get is called aspirin. So we are all familiar with this term aspirin because a very common medicine which has analgesic, anti-inflammatory and antipyretic properties. Now the reaction that essentially gives rise to the formation of aspirin is given here, where we can see that we are reacting salicylic acid with acetic anhydride in the presence of acid to give an ester, which is acetyl salicylic acid or otherwise called aspirin. So the detailed mechanism of esterification will be dealt in your next chapter, but to give you a glimpse of what happens in the mechanism, here you can see that the oxygen here is nucleophilic because it has lone pair of electrons, and this oxygen attacks, or the lone pair of electrons in this oxygen attacks this carbon, which is an electrophilic center. Now why is that? Because here we have a delta positive charge and delta minus here, as oxygen pulls the electron towards itself, making this carbon an electrophilic center. Now when this oxygen, or the lone pair of electrons in this oxygen, attacks this carbon, the bonds shift in such a way that now we have a CO minus. However, we also know that C double bond O is much stronger than C single bond O, and this essentially favors the restoration of the C double bond O group, and elimination of this group takes place, which is CH3CO minus. So here we can see CH3C double bond O, and this oxygen group gets added, resulting in the formation of an ester. So this is essentially an overview of what essentially happens in the mechanism of esterification. Details about this which will be dealt in your next chapter. I hope you are very clear on all the concepts that we have discussed in this video. Thank you.